Hi, today I'm going to show you how to classify credit default using Classification Learner app. First, we're going to import data into the MATLAB workspace. It is a sample credit card data. In this dataset, we have customer ID, credit limit, gender, educational level, age, number of delay payments, and historical billing amounts for the period of 6 months. Since we want to create a machine learning model to predict whether the client is going to default in the next 30 days or not, our response variable is default, where 1 is equal to default and 0 otherwise. Then let's go to the App tab and select the Classification Learner app. As we click on the new sessions here, the app will automatically detect the variables in the MATLAB workspace. Then we can select the dataset that we want to use. After that, the app will select if a variable is a predictor or a response based on the data type. However, we can also change its role or remove the variables. Let's deselect the ID as it is not relevant to default risk at all. To protect against problems like overfitting, I'm going to choose the holdout validation of 25%. It means that we are going to use 75% of the data for training and the rest for validating the model performance. Once we import the data into the app, we can visualize the relationship of predictor and response variables using the scatter plot here. When we adjust the predictor, we can see the new plot right away. Next, we are going to apply machine learning algorithms to train the data. To evaluate the default risk in practice, you may easily have hundreds of predictors. In such case, you may want to apply principal component analysis or PCA too. PCA is a useful technique for dimensionality reduction. However, we are going to leave this setting unchanged as we don't have many predictors in this dataset. And it's time for applying classification algorithms. There are many classifiers available for you to choose in the Classification Learner app. For example, decision trees, nearest neighbors, and supported vector machines. Here you can select the classifier and click train one by one. Or you can select a group of classifiers to train. And when we want to apply multiple algorithms at the same time, it is a good idea to use parallel computing to speed up the training process. It can be done in just one click. Let's select all classifiers and train. In this example, logistic regressions has the highest accuracy of 79.6%. In addition to the accuracy, there are other diagnostic tools that can provide more details about the performance of each classifier. To me, Confucian Metrics is one of the most intuitive and easiest metrics for evaluating the classification performance. The diagonal elements in green represent the validation samples that are correctly classified. On the other hand, the non-diagonal elements in red represent the validation samples that are misclassified. You can use the options here to view other types of Confucian metrics. When you complete the classification process, you can choose to directly export the model back to the MATLAB workspace or generate the MATLAB code. Let me choose this option. Now, we can also see the details of classification workflows. We can always customize the code and integrate into other applications. In this case, we may use this function to predict whether a client will default on the credit card in the next month or not. If the model predicts that the client is likely to default, the bank may use such data to prevent additional credit risks. For example, the bank may disapprove additional credit limit or lower the existing credit limit. Here we can see the performance of the trained model in the testing dataset. and accuracy is 78.3%. To learn more about machine learning algorithms and its applications, you can visit this webpage here. There are examples and videos related to machine learning available here. Thank you for watching this video.